Hey guys, welcome to Awesome Enterprise Video Tutorials. In this video, we will learn the MySQL queries in Awesome. So before moving to Awesome Enterprise MySQL queries, we'll just discuss a few points about MySQL queries. So we have different types of MySQL queries, like we can define our structure and we can manipulate our data and we can query our data. So to define or to handle the structure, we have create table, we have drop table, we can alter table, and we can truncate table. And to manipulate the data, we can insert, update, and delete. And in the select statement, we have variations while we are selecting the data. It means we can get the multiple rows or we get the single row. So according to this, in Awesome we have different types of provision while we are dealing with data query language. Now each of this we will go in deep in this video. In the next video we will check the transactional control language, that is the multi-query that we are saying. We will learn this one in the next video. In this video we will check these three types of queries, how we can do it in Awesome. Now let's start with the basic example. Now what we will do, we will create a table and we are manipulate those data in that table. So let's start by using the MySQL code. This short code will help us to handle these two types of queries. So we can define our structure and we can manipulate the data. So let's start with the basic example by creating the sample table in the database. So let's check this one. So we have written a query to create a table. In that we have two column, ID and name. So rest of the commands are commented. We will check all these commands one by one. Now let's go back and hit this. Now you can see the sample test table is created with ID and name. So we have just created the table, so no record is available in this table. Now let's comment this query and now we will insert two records in sample test table with Rajesh and Ramesh. Now let's go back and check one more time. As you can see, there are two records found. Now you can check the result of this as well. So it is showing that success and the message showing the affected rows. Now let's check the another example, that is we will update the record, the first with name Sam. Now let's go back and check. Now you can see, I'm just refreshing it, the name of the first ID is now Sam. Now you can check the delete statement. We are deleting the record, that is the Sham that we have updated recently, Sam. Now we will refresh it. Let me ensure that I have saved it. Yes, now you can see this record is deleted. Now only one record is available. Now let's go back and alter the table by using the alter command, alter table sample. We are adding one column with varchar 255. Now let's go back and change Now you can see the one more column is added. Now similarly, we can use the truncate the table command to vanish all the records from the table. Now you can see there will be no record in this table because we have truncated this. Now let's check the drop table. Now you can see the table called demo is there, and now we are just deleting that table. Now you can see demo table is not available. Now let's create or let's insert some few records in the sample test. As we have truncated the table, we don't have any record in that. Now let's insert. I'm just commenting this one. Now insert the record. As you can see, the result is same. If we refresh, then you can see the two records are inserted. Now this is what the MySQL i.code works. Now we will comment this code because we don't need this one, so I'm commenting this. Now let's check the other. As you can see, we have covered this one, the data definition language and the data manipulation language. So these queries we have checked with mysqli.code. Now we will move to handling the data query language with the select statement. So as you can see, we have variations in selecting the records. That is, we can have multiple rows, we can have single rows. So we will check all these one by one. So this will mysqli.fetch.rows, this will fetch the multiple rows from the table. Now let's check the output. So we have rows. In this we have array with status and the number of rows in the table. As you can see, we have only two rows, so the result is two rows. Found rows are two. So this is how the MySQLi.fetch.row works. Now let's assume you want only one row that should return. Now we have MySQLi.fetch.row and we are storing the result in row, result row. So we are using the select command, select star from sample test, where id is equal to 1. So this will return only one record. Now you can see the row, the variable added, that we are stored the result in row. As you can see, we have row variable array. In that we have only one record, and in rows, as you can see, there are two records because we are fetching all the rows here. Now let's move to exact one row. We have one more option to fetch exact one row. It is allies to fetch row. Now this will work similar to the row. Now you can see the row, only one row is available. You can see one row found. Now let's check the another one, column. So fetch only one column. Whenever you want to deal with only one value, one row or one column, then you have this option to fetch the one column. Now in this query we are fetching only name from the table, so for this I am using select fetch dot call in this select command, mysqli dot fetch dot call. Now let's go back and check. The column will have the names of the selected tables. So we are fetching the column name. As you can see, we have array. Now let's move towards the scalar. Now in this you have, whenever you want to deal with the aggregate function, that is mean, max, count, sum, that will return the single value, that time you have option, that is mysqli.fetch.scalar. This will fetch only one value. Now you can see the scalar result. You have a scalar, that is 2. So what we are doing is we are getting the count, how many rows are available in this table. We are using the count, so it means it will return only one value. So we have fetch dot scalar to get the single value. Now we have count mysqli dot fetch dot count. In this we are using the count one function to get the result, or to get the count as a result in array. Now let's go back and check the result.count. Now you can see the count is 2. Count is 2. The difference, the scalar and count, in the count it will return the row in a single value, and this will use when you want the aggregate function. This time you can use the scalar. So this will use to get the count of the affected rows. So this is how the MySQLi dot fetch and dot curd works with data definition language and data manipulation language and data query language. So these are, we have covered in this tutorial. So one thing that I want to highlight, we are using the single queries in this. So for the multiple queries, how we can do it with the transactional queries, that we are saying the multiple queries in Awesome. We will check this in the next video, and this is what the MySQLs are working in Awesome. Thank you.